Hello! Before we get on to our main topic today, I want to spend a little moment talking about what it's like to be mistreated as a musician. So when I was starting out in classical music, I wrote my first ever piano piece, and like any beginner, I was really, really proud of it and wanted more than anything else to hear it performed by a professional player. So I did a bit of searching online, and after a bit of time, found a guy who had some really amazing performance experience who said he'd be willing to try it out. So I sent him the sheet music, we agreed on a price, which wasn't insignificant for me, by the way, and after a few days waiting around kind of nervously, I got this email.
I can get started on this tomorrow. Can you please send a MIDI or Sibelius file so I can create a guide tempo track?
Now, that's quite an unusual request, which I've not been asked since by any pianist I've worked with, because it's kind of embarrassing to ask for a click track to help you perform. Not to mention the score I gave him was fairly conventional, so I was reasonably sure he'd be able to work it out. So with all that in mind, it was a little difficult to avoid the suspicion that what this guy was thinking of doing was taking my MIDI file and simply running it through some realistic piano sampler rather than bothering to play it, hoping, I guess, that I'd be so inexperienced I wouldn't know the difference between a computer's performance and a real human one. So I asked, about the MIDI Sibelius file, I'm just making sure that you're not misunderstanding what I'm looking for and planning to put this together in a DAW like Cubase rather than record an actual acoustic performance.
The MIDI track is for creating a click guide for time signature changes. I don't use Cubase.
So, trusting this guy knew more than me, I set aside my concerns, paid the money, and a few days later got an email with a recording that confirmed my worst fears. Yes, it was just my MIDI file played through a bad sampler with a few bogus tempo adjustments thrown in to make it sound like a few human mistakes had been made. It wasn't even a good attempt at fakery. Compare this with an actual performance of the same piece that I recorded later. When I called the performer out on this, he insisted it was my ears that were the problem and that I didn't have the required experience to make judgments about his performance. Basically, he thought that I was so inexperienced, I'd be willing to accept something of incredibly low quality. Now, this is by no means the first time I've been taken for a ride as a musician. Before I had any classical training, I used to play in bands in the underground scene in Ireland, and during that time, I've been sold faulty equipment, not been paid for performances, I mean that happened constantly, I've been given all kinds of bad advice by people who were supposedly more knowledgeable than me. Go back even further to when I was 4, I used to have a violin teacher who shrieked at me and called me a fool for getting my scales wrong, to the point where I gave up the violin. Now, the point of all of this is, I remember what it was like to be a beginner, constantly ripped off and misinformed and just made to feel small. And I say this because I'm about to tear into a service now that's ostensibly for beginners, that promises to help you make great music without needing to feel confused, that promises to deliver you from all the elitists and gatekeepers who'd flaunt their knowledge and give nothing back. This service claims to be the middle finger that you can raise to those who'd lord their knowledge over you. And the only problem with that claim is it's complete f***ing horseshit. The classic playbook for most startups is to identify an enemy, which is usually some kind of old or inefficient practice, and then position your product as a liberation from that practice. When music apps take this approach, especially ones aimed at beginners, the enemy is all too often some aspect of music education. Most commonly, music theory, music teachers, notation, the fact that learning an instrument isn't easy, or some accusation of gatekeeping or elitism. For example, a few years ago, Musician took aim at music teachers and suggested that you shouldn't use them because their bouncy ball garbage app was, quote, the best way to learn guitar. Now, as a musician who's had some really good guitar teachers and also as a designer who's worked on some music practice apps, this is a laughable statement. However, they're not advertising to me. They're hoping, like the guy who sold me my own MIDI, that beginners won't know any better. And with that in mind, step forward Unison, a brand easily remembered because their icon resembles the U-bend of a toilet. I mean, this obviously isn't their logo. I've put a link in the description so you can see the real thing for yourself. Okay, I should probably explain. You see, Unison have a bit of a history of trying to silence their critics by hitting them with DMCA takedown notices, which cite copyright infringement. For example, they hit the YouTuber Av McCree with a takedown after he gave them an unfavorable review.
Like there was nothing in there that had anything to do with Unison Audio outside of maybe like a logo.
And when this story was reported by CDM and another blog called Discord, they were both hit by takedown notices from Unison Audio too. What were they striking? Like what was it you did that they claimed DMCA on?
So they said that my website itself was including copyright infringing material. And that copyright infringing material was me posting a video of Ave saying that Unison Audio made a DMCA claim against him.
Of course, that's ridiculous. They both rejected the claims immediately and Unison backed down. Issuing takedowns to shut critical voices up is a well-established tactic, and one I'm pretty used to dealing with. However, in this video, I actually feel that this presents a fun creative restriction to work within, so I'm not going to be showing anything copyrighted or trademarked by Unison Audio at all. No shots of their products or website, no clips from their videos, not even their logo. And as you'll see in a moment, this isn't actually too much of a problem because their offerings are almost 90% illusion. Now, if you've somehow not seen one of their ads and you want to get familiar before we continue, check out the link I mentioned a moment ago, watch that for a few seconds, and then come back to me. So if you want a quick indication of how Unison's customers feel about them, a quick visit to Trustpilot will reveal the following ratings. Excellent, 10%. Great, 0%. Average, 0%. Poor, 7%. And bad, 83%. Unison's flagship product is a thing called the MIDI Chord Pack, a folder full of MIDI files containing either individual chords or chord progressions that you can drag and drop into a music app. For example, here's a folder called C major that contains 7 basic root position chords that are all in the key of C major. That's right, it's literally that basic. By the way, these are my own MIDI chords with a slightly different naming convention because it occurred to me that Unison might try a copyright claim if I named my C major MIDI chords the way they named theirs. No, I actually think they'd really try that. Now, apart from basic major chords, you also have your relative minor chords along with a few borrowed chords. Again, the organization you see here is a little different, but the idea is the same. In addition, each key comes with a few chord progressions which are nearly always 4 bars long and occasionally 8 bars long. In total, Unison provide just over 1200 MIDI files. Sounds like a lot of work, until you realize that they only had to create this once for one key, with the other 12 keys simply being transposed versions of the same thing. For those who don't know what I mean, if you want all your chords and chord progressions from C major to be in D major, there, just do that. So, apart from being easy to make, what are the problems with this product? Well, I'm going to break it down into 3 things and I'll expand upon them all later. First, at $67 when there's no promotion on, it's wildly overpriced and very poor quality, even for a MIDI pack. Second, the product is explicitly sold as something that's going to help you produce polished music, promising to leapfrog you to a successful professional status, which is nonsense. Third, as with all technologists, Unison claims to be contributing towards a social good by providing an alternative to musical education, which it repeatedly casts as a negative thing, using the problematic dog whistle term music theory as a catch-all for what's holding musicians back from reaching their potential. And I mean, I suppose if musical education didn't exist, then I guess we wouldn't know there was anything to be learned and then we could all enjoy MIDI packs forever. Hold on, let me just shove this knife into my brain.
Feedback on accuracy.
Sup, my name's Mac from Flush Valve, and I'm proud to announce to you today the one and only Flush Valve MIDI Chord Pack.
MIDI Chord Pack.
Chord Pack.
MIDI Pack.
MIDI Chord Pack. MIDI Chord Pack.
Basically, it's over 1,000 chords that will take you to the next level in the music industry, like me. Wait, you never heard of me? You never heard of Mac from Flush Valve? I've got over 12,000 listens on Spotify per month. Basically, if you know Mac from Flush Valve, you'll know that I only use pro-level chords. I'm not talking about novice chords or apprentice chords, I'm talking about pro-level chords that will blow your family away, make your friends think you're a genius, and get you that recognition you've always wanted from the music industry. Now you might be thinking, Mac from Flush Valve, what the f*** is a pro-level chord? Doesn't make any f***ing sense. Well, basically, when a chord is 3 notes, if you add another note, now it's pro-level. And basically, the more pro-level chords you have, the more music points you gather, which takes you up to pro-level, like me. I have over 12,000 listens a month. Slade have 700,000 listens a month. Rebecca Black has 480,000 listens a month. The Thrills, an Irish one-hit wonder who disbanded in 2008, have 100,000 listens a month. So how did I, a contemporary artist who brags about a Spotify profile on ads that reach millions of people, achieve 12,000 listens a month by using pro-level chords? And the best part is that you can achieve the same pro-level without any need for music theory, which is mind-numbing and boring. Music education is no good for you. Music theory is a waste of time. When I was starting out, I was really frustrated with my junior to elementary level chords. I tried everything to improve improve. I watched every YouTube tutorial. I bought every sample pack. I even spent over $27,503 studying production at the Arts Institute in Vancouver. And even after all that, I still couldn't figure out the art of pro-level chords. So despite the fact that I've just admitted to not knowing anything, I've now got the solution to not knowing anything. That's why I can say the Flush Valve MIDI Chord Pack is the most pro-level chords available in the industry, because I don't have the experience to invalidate my own claims.
I don't think I'm gonna be dealing with this noise anymore.
Who the hell would study, like, music theory?
Music theory is just so boring.
You don't need to spend ages learning music theory.
Listening to your heart rather than what some old jazz man wanted to teach you.
You know what? I'm gonna take this and I'm just gonna put it in the bin.
All this mind-numbing plinky-plonky business, it's all just pointless.
Learning is stupid.
And by the way, these chords mean you don't have to spend any extra time producing. What does that mean? It means they're great. The moment you drag them into your project is pro level. There's no need to do any extra production, because the moment you drag the chord in, stop. Just stop creating. It's done. Here's a beat I made that's completely pro. It's in 4/4 at 120 BPM because I don't know how to change that default in my DAW. Now if I add these chords, listen to that.
All right, let's see what this baby's got. See how it runs.
Ah! Oh! Oh! Ooh!
Damn.
Ooh!
Wait, what?
Oh, I could never think of a progression like that.
And that's it. There's your song, right there.
It's just the next hit. You guys know, right?
Alright, that is, without a doubt, pro-level harmony. Right there, right in the can, just like that.
Next level pro chords. If you do this, you'll be famous tomorrow. It's compatible with all DAWs because all DAWs have been supporting basic MIDI for the last 30 years. It's compatible with both Mac and PC because it's just folders with MIDI files in it. Basically, all you have to do is spend $67 and you'll automatically be a famous artist like me, Mac from Flush Valve. Now you might say, Mac from Flush Valve, why do I need your chords when I can just use a free open source pack that has 5 times as much content as yours does? I'll give you my Mac from Flush Valve response. Do you want to be lame? Flush Valve's C major is better than all other C majors because of the vibe of it. And by the way, for a limited time only, if you buy our MIDI chord pack, you can also pick up our Flush Valve vowel pack for free. A, E, I, O, and U. If you want pro words, you gotta have pro vowels. Basically, you just open your text editor and copy and paste your vowels for pro words. It works with any text editor or browser. It works with both Mac and PC. With pro words, you can write novels that will blow away your family and friends and finally get you noticed in the publishing industry. And if you act now, we'll add over 75 word progressions that you can copy and paste right into your text. I like the way the man kicked the ball. I think what you are doing is great. Let's go up there. Why would you think when you can spend money so that you don't have to think? Why would you think? I didn't think, and I have over 12,000 listens a month on Spotify. Education is mind-numbing. Flush Valve, why would you think?
So before I go any further on Unison Audio, I want to be sure I'm being clear about MIDI chord packs themselves. There's nothing musically wrong with the idea of dragging a chord into a project, especially if you're using it as a jumping off point for experimentation. There are actually a few practical applications I can think of for advanced users too, like it could function as a quick way of trying out polytonal ideas, or generating random sequences with scripting, etc. If you're a beginner getting to grips with the complexities of music technology and recording, this might be an okay starting off point. However, it's my pretty firm opinion that regardless of your chosen style and genre, you'll only be capable of reaching a professional level when you move beyond systems like this and develop a more intricate understanding of the music writing techniques that's suitable for your genre. This flies in the face of Unison's advertising, which can be seen by looking at three of their selling points. Go beyond basic chords with advanced chords and progressions so your music can stand out. This is a weird promise. All their major and minor chords are in root position only, and if you don't know what that means, well, the real point is that chords can be rearranged into multiple different positions depending on the number of notes involved. It's a simple skill to learn and crucial to being able to manipulate harmony effectively. The idea that Unison would use the term pro-level chords when they haven't even got a solution for basic positioning really does set my teeth on edge. So what about their chord progressions then? Well, there's not very many of them. They only provide 12 for the major key, 12 for the minor key, and then another 12 advanced progressions.
Advanced.
also for major and minor, for a grand total of 48 progressions. Of course, they count it as 576 progressions because they're using the same 48 progressions in each of the 12 keys. Again, for those who don't know what I mean, here's a progression in one key. If you move it up like this, now it's in a different key. They just counted this one thing as 12 things. Now, I did notice one or two deviations in how the notes were ordered in certain keys, but the progressions themselves were the same each time. And the majority of these progressions are so run-of-the-mill, they'd be embarrassing to use. Like, listen to this one. That sounds like an ad for life insurance. And even if you do find one you like, everyone else has the same progression, so how exactly is this going to make your music stand out by default? By being conspicuously generic? Skyrocket your progress as a producer by finishing more tracks than ever. This promise is bizarre. The basic chords they provide are just data. They don't even have a sound until you pick an instrument to assign them to, and even then you're gonna need to manipulate the sounds and produce the result. They can argue that the pack provides the bass blocks that help you get started, sure, but there's nothing here that helps with anything past that point. No aspect of production is covered here. It doesn't develop your chords into an actual musical idea, it doesn't help you choose sounds or apply effects, it doesn't help you mix or master the final output. I am unconvinced. Eliminate the need for complex music theory so you can focus on what matters most. Well, what matters most? I'm going to guess that for anyone willing to invest the money to better their songwriting, what matters most to them is that they're happy with the music they write and that they're able to see it resonating with those who listen to it. And if I'm right about that, then take it from me. I didn't study formal music theory until after I'd been in a band for about 10 years, and even when I did study theory, I found I actually already knew quite a lot of it, stuff I just picked up due to being an active songwriter. The point is, learning is a crucial part of being an effective musician, regardless of whether that learning involves music theory, and a MIDI chord pack isn't going to fast track anyone past the need to know their craft. And as for music theory, you don't need to study theory to feel comfortable as a writer, but don't buy the line that learning about how others wrote music is a waste of time, or that it's even really that hard. 6-year-olds study grade 1 music theory in the UK, and there's a lot of it you can just skip past. Believe it or not, that's actually the more sane stuff. Now, we need to delve into the crazy, because with Unison, there's a lot of crazy. Prepare for a U-bend in your brain. One, it's already out there and it's free. The most ridiculous thing about Unison's offerings is that no matter what way you slice it, there's a better option for free. So if you use a DAW, the thing Unison chords are meant to be dragged into, then the chances are you already own a much better alternative. In Reason, for example, there's a tool called Scales and Chords. It takes a few minutes to get the hang of, but look, once you open it, you can just press a single note and it will play the appropriate chord depending on your selected key and settings. You can choose the number of notes per chord, the ordering of the notes, you even have this little toggle called Color, which suggests some slightly jazzier alternatives. Now if I add an arpeggio tool, listen to how you can just fiddle with it in real time. In Cubase, there's the Chord Assistant. With FL Studio, there's a really nice option integrated right into its piano roll. In Ableton, there's a free plugin called the Nordman Chord Generator, among others. These are all far more sophisticated, usable, and well integrated than a list of static files. And even if you still, for some reason, want a MIDI chord pack because you just really like the look of it and you want to try it out, then there's already a larger and better and free open source chord pack available. That's right, it's called SHLD, and you can get it right now. The link is in the description. And when speaking to the creator of this chord pack, I found out something you might be interested in.
I took two existing Python modules, which are Mingus and Chords to MIDI. Maybe 1 hour later, my chord pack was done.
You're kidding, it took you an hour.
Yes.
And this leads me to two. You could make this MIDI chord pack in no time. One of Unison's ads talks about the hundreds of hours and thousands in development costs that went into creating their chord pack. Which might be true if at every decision point in the production process they deliberately chose the most time-consuming option available to them as a kind of challenge. Let's just imagine how we could make this ourselves. If it was me, I'd use that Reason feature I told you about, setting the options appropriately for complexity and mode, and then just transposing the final settings 12 times to cover each key. Then I'd do the same for chord progressions. Chords and chord progressions by themselves can't be copyrighted, so I could sell this if I was so inclined. 3. Terminology. Unison have amazing turns of phrase. My favorite is obviously pro-level chords. I just love the idea that a single chord could emanate professionalism. For those who don't know, chords are like words in that they're not just brilliant in isolation. You have to put them in sequence. And just like you can't walk over to someone and say, recalcitrant, and expect their minds to be blown, a chord isn't just going to top the charts by itself. I mean, maybe it will one day, I don't know. Another little selling point of theirs is that their pack is royalty-free. Hey guys, this is great! I can finally use C major royalty-free. That's like selling someone a dictionary on the basis that it grants them the right to use words. Another claim I love relates to one of their products, the MIDI Wizard, a tool which automatically generates crap MIDI chord progressions. According to Unison, the chords it produces actually sound good 93% of the time. Handily, on the same page as this quote can be found a few audio examples which I assume are there to provide proof of this claim. So to test this statistic, I created a poll on both YouTube and Twitter, and unfortunately, the findings I got back were a little different. How confusing. So with all that said, what is it Unison are doing that's actually effective? That's the scale of their digital advertising. They pay for a lot of it. So if you've searched for something vaguely related to Unison, once your IP is recognized, you can't not see them. Type Ableton into Google, Unison MIDI chord pack, top of the page. Search FL Studio, it's the second ad down, the one under FL Studio. Searching for music production tutorials on YouTube, Unison is everywhere, with ads featuring a collection of influencers who seem to have no problem shilling garbage to vulnerable beginners. The business logic is clear. Create a product that doesn't require any maintenance and advertise it at scale. It doesn't matter if the product's garbage or if your advertising contradicts what's in your product, because if you advertise broadly enough, some people will pay for it. Why? Because they're innocent and excited. They're just like me when I was sold my own MIDI file. And that takes me to my last point. I don't think that the apparent success of Unison, who recently bragged that they've made 100,000 sales of their MIDI pack, should be seen as an indication of how lazy people are or something like that. This whole idea of encouraging laziness and talking about learning your craft as if it's a chore is Unison's fiction. You shouldn't let it get you down because you feel it's an indication that music is in decline or something like that. It's just a bunch of jerks masquerading as musical revolutionaries to fool people into parting with their money. And if their Trustpilot score is anything to go by, it looks like they're not going to be able to fool those people a second time. That money's only going down the U-bend once, then everyone's going to learn and move on. And with that in mind, Unison does actually provide a useful experience that can help you learn as a musician, by helping you recognize garbage when you see it.
If you like my diatribe, subscribe!